Amen? Amen. God made her barren. And each day the Bible says that Hannah will go to Shiloh, place of worship, where prophet
Eli,
high priest Eli, was the priest. And the Bible says that Hannah will pray to God. This strong prayer I ask us not to do. Say, God, bless me. Give me child. So that Phinehas, my co-wife, will stop laughing at me. Give me child so she will know that I am not barren. God, give me child so that my enemies will see that I can as well have my own kids. And God never had her. She will go to the altar and pray and pray and pray. God never heard. At a point, the Bible says, Eli thought she was drunk. And then I asked her, Hannah, when will you stop drinking? Because she will come and she couldn't pray again. She couldn't utter a word. The Bible says her tears counted for her. But one day, guess what happened? She realized she was making the wrong prayers. And the Bible says she came back and said to the Lord, now look at what she said. He said, God, the land needs a prophet. Give me a child and I will raise you a prophet.
Amen.
He says, the land needs a prophet. Give me a child and I will raise you a prophet. Now, she wasn't talking about her ego. She wasn't talking about her pride. She was talking about the kingdom business. Amen. And what happened? Bam! Just once.
Yeah.
Just once.
Yeah.
She became pregnant. And God is a covenant-keeping God.
Mm-hmm.
The moment she got pregnant, guess what Hannah did? She had a little boy called Samuel. Mm-hmm. She dedicated the child to God.
Amen.
So we make prayers. Oh God, my family is falling apart. My enemies will laugh at me. Oh no, my business. Oh God, don't let them. Oh no. That's the wrong prayer.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't matter how you prayed. It doesn't matter how you prayed. People can laugh at you. But God, David says, God, search in me and see if there's any hidden iniquity in me. That's the prayer of David. David was the greatest sinner you can ever imagine in the Bible. But he was a man after God's own heart.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was submissive to the will of God. So it doesn't matter. The Bible says our righteousness is like a filthy rag. I can pretend to be righteous before you guys. I can pretend and say, hey, you guys say, wow, hell is so. But in my secret chamber, I am not what you thought I am. But David, understanding that point, he says, God, search in me and see if there's any hidden iniquity. So when you pray to God, having no iniquity in your heart, start dancing. No, he has heard you. It doesn't matter. You don't need any prophet. You don't need any pastor. You don't need nobody. Pray for yourself.
Hallelujah.
And when it gets worse, that's when you need a brother. That's why the Bible says iron. Sharpened iron. So when we come here, we don't come here to discuss each other's problem. We come here to uplift you in the spirit. And let me tell you something. You can't defeat your situation physically. The Bible says it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the spirit of the living God.
Yes.
That's why before someone dies in the physical, he has already died in the spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
We are spiritual beings. Devil told Adam and Eve, hey, when you eat of this fruit, you will die. They were thinking it was a physical death. No.
Wow.
No. Devil. Nobody's more anointed than devil. Nobody, no preacher is more anointed than devil. Devil has tested it. Someone that communes with God, someone that visits God. So whatever you talk about anointing, devil has the anointing. Devil can heal the sick. Devil can raise the dead. Devil can do anything. So when you, I told my wife the first time we met, I said, hey, be careful who lays hand on you. Did I tell you that? I did.
Yeah.
I said, be careful who lays hand on you. Be sensitive to the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says my people perish because of lack of wisdom.
Mm.
You go to this man, oh, he's a prophet, he said this. Don't do it. Bless you, my son. Don't do it. Everybody here, I've never prayed for any of them. When he comes out, tell him, provoke him to go and pray for himself. I'll back him up in the realm of the spirit.
Yes.
Because when I pray for you, that means that I am taking the glory. God is raising choice.